Hey, Zak, I don't know who you think you is. I'm coming for your wife, your family, and even your kids. And really, this can get ugly. This is for all the times that you ducked me. You stepped on my turf. That was your first mistake. And you never know what it feels like to be great.
Hey, yo, son, listen, you ain't really about this, trying to make me move, bitch. That's just ludicrous. For stepping to me, you must be out your fucking mind. And you can front all you want, that's just fine. Because if you slip, I got this clip, this knife that sticks, and this nine that kicks. So no tough guy shit. I'm a G with a strong D. Ask your chick, she's a freak and she's on me. I'm just that slick. She's crawling with weak knees cause she wrote my dick. I'm a thug and an MC who kills shit quick. I'll wait till you leave your crib, tie up your girl and your kid with guns to both heads. You can choose the one that lives. If you try to be a hero, I wouldn't want to be you, cause I'll stuff this double barrel down your throat and have you swallowing shells like seafood. But hey yo, I got a lot more, so shut up and listen. You'll be flat on the floor, Ali versus listen. You'll always be in my shadow like Jordan did Pippin. You'll get stretched by this cross like the very first Christian. Or get this pumping iron without all the lifting. Man, I'll keep these hooks coming like I was fishing. Then I'll twist off your top like I can in the kitchen. Boy, you fucked with the wrong one. I know you couldn't expect this, but you could never fuck with me. I'm just too goddamn reckless. Hurry the fuck up, spit that shit.
Alright, Zak, you're not even worth my time. I'ma have both these girls finish my rhymes.
Man, that all you got? I said, yo, Zak. Yo, shut the fuck up, man.
Come on, put your hood up and hit the shower.
Fuck!
Fuck
him!
Hey, what the fuck? You gonna clean that up, bitch?
Gummy sharks, three slushies,
and all the fucking money in the drawer. Get the fucking money. You're lucky I don't blow your goddamn head off for the way you just spoke to her. If you don't want your fucking brains to end up like that cherry slushy, I advise you to give me all the goddamn money. You dumb bitch. Come on, hurry up.
thanks. I guess.
How'd you get cracked?
Because Jerry's a fucking asshole?
Could've told you that.
What the fuck is this?
It was a slow night.
A slow night. Take that.
Thanks.
Now give it back.
What?
Give it back! And say, Daddy, I want you to have this. This is for you. Say it! Say it! One. Two.
What's wrong with you?
What?
You just saw me blow a man's brains across a gas station window and you hopped in my car without even saying a word.
This isn't your car. You blew a man's brains out and I shot a man in the heart. We have something in common. Did you feel it?
Feel what?
The rush. That warm rush that slowly takes over your body when you pull that trigger. The thrill of it. You felt it, didn't you? I know you did. I can see it in your eyes. It's nothing like you've ever experienced before, is it? The sensation slowly takes over your entire body. The warmth of age. With the rush of coke. The euphoria of X. But the high of Lucy. It's nothing like taking a drug, though. It's much, much more. It's taking a life.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends.
Hey, this way.
What's the matter?
If you go into the shop, you're gonna miss out.
What the hell are you talking about?
If we go into the shop, the people in the office are gonna hear all the screaming and get the hell out of Dodge. We're stuck with the money from the register. Starting the office, we get all the cash of the office workers, not to mention wedding rings, watches, phones, you name it.
It's like 9 at night. There's not gonna be anybody here. It's
a 24-hour help desk for some tech company. People are always here.
How did you find out about this dump anyway?
Does it matter? After you, my lady.
Put the money in the bag. Hurry up.
Hello, everyone. This is, in fact, a robbery. My beautiful partner in crime here will be walking around collecting your valuables. Yes. Pun intended. So please hold your wallets, rings, earrings, necklaces, watches, and any other jewelry you may have on you out to be collected. I really do not want to hurt anyone. So if no one fucks with us, no one gets fucked with.
Ooh, that one was Instagram worthy. Wow, you're really photogenic, I must say. Are you scared? Are you afraid of me? Oh, and it's so cute. You're just such a sweet boy. Yeah, you are. Hurry up. Put that in. Put your fucking coffee down! You're getting robbed! Jesus Christ!
Everyone to the middle and sit in a circle. We're gonna play a game.
Just junk the damn thing. Get yourself a new car. In fact, I have a Civic sitting outside for sale.
Just how much to fix this one? I don't need it.
Stay here.
Duck. Duck. Goof.
Hey, asshole! Drop it!
Fuck!
Shh. Throw the gun into the hallway!
Fuck.
I swear to God, I will blow her fucking brains out of her goddamn skull! I'm not joking! I'm gonna count to three! One! Two! Three! I'm serious, asshole!
Call me asshole one more time. Drop the girl.
Fuck you!
Just fucking shut him!
Do that again, and the next one finds the kid's head. I guess it's your lucky day. Now, fucking walk. What?
You fucking killed a kid.
She wasn't a kid.
She was like 17. 17 is a fucking kid.
But the three other people I executed, you have no problem with. Why is it that now you decided to act like you never put a bullet in someone?
I haven't.
Bull.
I haven't fucking killed a single person. What the fuck is wrong with you, fucking psychopath?
He wasn't a kid.
Fuck you.
They're dead. There's nothing you can do about it. So, get the hell over it.
Hey guys, what's going on?
Not much, officer. Just, taking in the winter night.
We got a call for some gunshots up here. We're here to check into it.
Gun! Of course, the bloodbath in the 24-hour IT office again, touching off the nationwide debate over gun control. And that's what brings in our two guests tonight. We're going to start with David Dickerson, gun rights advocate. David, what do you have to say about the way that this incident played itself out?
Thank you, Chip, for having me on your show. I'm honored to speak on the subject, and I like to think I'm an authority. I can say that I heard about this Paul character, and I can't speak to why he failed everyone in that room and failed us as Americans, but I can speak to the idea behind it. If there was someone else in that room who was, let's say, more a man than Paul was and had a gun on them, then none of this would have happened. Not one part of it. And if I may, Chip, I'd like to give you an example of just what I'm talking about. You see, here's little Johnny. Here's little Johnny, Chip. And here's little Johnny being picked on by a couple of low-level thugs like those losers. Oh, and look, Chip, here is little Johnny pulling out a Glock 45 caliber, Chip. Oh, and better yet, here is little Johnny peppering them with bullets, Chip, riddling them with good, God-loving, all-American bullets, Chip. Johnny wins in this situation, Chip.
So, David, what you're saying here, then, is more guns, more violence would have made this a better outcome?
Certainly not. No, I mean to say, I'm not, Chip, abdicating for more violence. No, I'm suggesting that if every American would exercise their God-given gift of a right to arm themselves with a gun, then probably this circumstance couldn't have taken place.
Well, in the interest of balance, we want to bring in Chris Collar, who is here to give us the gun control argument on this. Chris.
Well, hey, Chip. Thank you for having me on your show. I just want to say that we live in a country where we have far more guns than people.
Chris, let me cut you off there just a second. What's this? All right, we're going to have to break away from the discussion. Breaking news happening now. Kim Kardashian's new pair of shoes coming up after this.
What do we do now? Things are never gonna be the same, are they?
Come on out with your hands up. Drop your weapon. Put them down.